Ooh, we're gonna have fun.
Yes.
The letter. Toad was sitting on his front porch. Frog came along and said, "What is the matter, Toad? You are looking sad."
"Yes," said Toad. "This is my sad time of day. It is the time when I wait for the mail to come. It always makes me very unhappy."
"Why is that?" asked Frog.
Because I never get any mail," said Toad.
"Not ever?" asked Frog.
"No, never," said Toad. "No one has ever sent me a letter. Every day my mailbox is empty. That is why waiting for the mail is a sad time for me."
Frog and Toad sat on the porch, feeling sad together. Then Frog said, "I have to go home now, Toad. There is something that I must do." Frog hurried home. He found a pencil and a piece of paper. He wrote on the paper. He put the paper in an envelope, and on the envelope he wrote a letter for Toad. Frog ran out of his house. He saw a snail that he knew. "Snail," said Frog, "please take this letter to Toad's house and put it in his mailbox."
"Sure," said the snail, "right away."
Oh, every night, New Year's Eve.
One, two, three.
Happy birthday, Cameron.
Miss you.
Should I stop filming now?
Yeah. You want?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Cameron. Happy birthday to you.
We love you, and we hope that your 25th is the best one yet, and all of the years to come. Can't wait to see you and make more memories. Talk to you soon. Happy birthday.
Bye.
Oh, hey. I didn't see you there. This one's for you, Cameron. Happy birthday. I have no idea how to play the guitar. And while I have you, can you let Jimmy's mom know I need a new pair of glasses? He's broke a couple weeks ago.
I'm not gonna go with the big speech, so I'll just say this. I wish you the happiest birthday.
Happy birthday, Cameron. We hope you have a great day. Love you, miss you.
Happy birthday, Cameron.
So Cameron, on your birthday, I thought that we should share some lovely warm memories.
But then this video would go on forever. So I thought that I would make up some witty one-liners.
But honey, you're really not all that funny. So since we're already sitting at the bar.
Oh, my bar. I made this bar. See?
Okay, your bar.
Well, we should probably get on with the toast.
So Cameron, on your 25th birthday, we want you to know that...
yeah, we're drinking without you.
Cheers to you, Cameron.
Happy birthday!
Me, Joe. I was told it was your birthday, so since I'm working with electronics, I figured I'd rig up a circuit that plays the happy birthday song. So, here we go. Happy birthday, Cammy.
Happy birthday, Cammy. From Uncle Mike and Aunt Cheryl and Tula.
Hey, Cameron. Hope you're having a happy birthday. I know it's crazy to have one in this year. It's been a crazy year all around. I had one at the beginning of the lockdown, so it's pretty whack. But anyway, I hope it's happy and you have a good day. And maybe get a part of or have another cam jam. I remember seeing and at least being able to listen while you and Jamie got the little jam out at the ATO house once, and that was a good time. So. I hope your birthday has something cool like that happening. Anyway, so happy birthday.
Remember that trip we took to New Orleans with the boys? And they were working the entire weekend, and we just sat and drank wine and ate peanut brittle. And I shared things with you that I've never shared with anyone, and you made me realize how I can trust people again. So let me just say, Cameron, you're my best friend, and I'm so proud of you. And chum. Sorry, inside joke. Let me just say, happiest of birthdays, and I still need my drunken Saturday nights at Rockin' Sushi, okay?
Hi, Cam. Just wanted to wish you a happy birthday. Lev wants you to know that you need to have a happy birthday, too. I'd invite Kevin over, but he'd probably try to fight with one, so just one. Happy birthday.
Hi, Cameron. Happy birthday. Me and Marvin wanted to wish you... Oh, big yawn. We wanted to wish you a happy birthday. I wish so badly that I could be there celebrating with you in person, but hopefully I can plan a trip out to see you and Jamie soon. Yeah, I hope you have a great day.
Hey, Cameron. Happy birthday. I hope that you're doing well and staying safe and healthy in this crazy time. Everything's kind of been weird lately, and I haven't seen you in forever, and I hope that changes soon. It's a nice day here in Ottawa Lake, kind of. Nothing around me right now, but I hope you're having nice weather there too, and I want to hear you and Jamie sing again soon. Just have a great day. I hope that everything is well. See ya.
Kapkunka. Kapkunka.
Hi, Cam. So, I thought about talking about your unique solution to being Merlin in Avalon. Instead, though, I'm going to focus on a different story. So imagine, if you will, those little reflectors that you see on the highway. Now think about every single one of those you've ever seen in your entire life, and then multiply that number by a thousand or so. Then take all those reflectors and put them on a 5 to 10 mile stretch somewhere south of Knoxville at around 2 o'clock in the morning in early January. Well, that was the experience we had, and as you were driving us to the joint mathematics meeting, Tanu exclaimed to everybody that there are stars on the highway. And that, I remember the excitement on your face and the beauty of it at the time. So, happy birthday, Cam, to the bee's knees.
Happy birthday, Cam.
Big 25.
We hope you're having a blast and a good time wherever you are. Is she in Michigan?
I'm not sure.
I don't know.
Where
if
you're
in you? Michigan. Where are you?
I know you're drinking coffee in the morning, though.
And hopefully alcohol tonight. We love you. Have a good celebration.
That's right.
Bye.
Bye.
Miss you.
I took Spanish together in school, so I just want to say really quick to everyone here, gracias para vivir en la casa, en las escuelas, en azul biblioteca.
Hi, Cam. Happy birthday. We're looking forward to celebrating with you really soon.
Even if we have to celebrate belatedly, we're so happy you've been in our lives these past several months. You've brought us a lot of joyful things, board games, karaoke at home, indoors, quarantine karaoke, and you've made Alex really happy, and we're glad to have you as a friend. Happy birthday! Happy birthday!
Happy 25th birthday, Cameron!
From Sarah.
Sarah.
Emily.
And Tuna!
Cammy Cakes, what's going on? It's Barnett here from Love is Blind. Your friends Alex, Jamie, and Keegan told me that you are turning 25. Well, I wanted to stop by and say happy birthday. Hope it's awesome. Hope you can celebrate. They told me a lot about you. You're an awesome banana bread baker. Well, that's pretty great. I love me some good banana bread. You have a great family, and you love them. Rob, Lolly, Shelly, and Jill. They sound pretty cool. And you have awesome mixtape making abilities. You always make some bangers for Chum. So, yeah, you play Ambassador and Coop. I don't know what that is. Sounds awesome. Is that a play? You have to DM me and tell me about it. And you love Coldwater Lake and Spy Pond. And also don't know what those are. Movies, shows, doesn't sound like anything. Unless they're games. I don't know. Anyways. Happy birthday. Go Chi Omega. See ya.
I feel so close to you and can trust you, and you're my angel and my soulmate, and I feel that I can communicate with you with simply a look. Chum.
Hey Cam, happy birthday. As you can tell, I definitely procrastinated on making this video. But here I am, and here's my favorite Cam memory. And that would have to be Team Not Stay in the Dark. Because we're the only players on Time Team that ever had any sense. And I hope that we can really whip the Time Team into shape in our upcoming post-quarantine gaming sessions. So happy birthday again, and we'll see you soon.
Hey Cameron, happy 25th birthday to you. I hope you have a great day today and able to spend it with many friends and family, whether that's in person or over the phone. I also want to say that I miss you and I miss all of Math Fam. It feels like it wasn't too long ago when we were able to spend time almost every single day together when we were at Adrian. And I'd say one of my favorite memories of all of Math Fam was when we went to Atlanta for the JMM conference. And where I had to make my 72-point turn because I entered the wrong parking structure. And also when we explored Atlanta and we stumbled upon that one bar that didn't even have our eighth selection of beer because they were all out. And I'd say the funniest moment was when we went to the poetry jam or the poetry slam. And we saw that one guy recite his poetry with two syllables at a time. That was probably my favorite moment of that whole trip. But anyway, I just want to wish you a happy birthday, and I just hope you have a great day. All right, take care.
Happy birthday, Cam. I think my favorite memory about you is when you and Jamie were looking for cats to adopt on Pet Finder, and you found this pair of twin cats. But strangely, there was only one cat in each picture, and I remember you guys wondering, like, where the heck is the other cat? Come to find out that right like in the corner of the picture frame was the second cat like awkwardly sniffing the other cat's butt or something like that. And I think its name was Tantalus. And oh my God, that was the hardest I've ever seen you laugh, ever. And it was just so funny to see that like tickled you so much. Also just wanted to say it's been a blast meeting your friends, your family. Clearly, you are a reflection of them and they're a reflection of you. And it's a really beautiful thing. You have a lot of incredible people in your life. And it's been incredible to share the past few months with you too. So happy birthday. Love you very much and can't wait for Michigan in a few weeks.
Happy birthday, Cammy, on the special 25th birthday. I miss you so much. I'm used to you being near. Can't wait to see you in July. Again, have a wonderful year. I love you, and hugs and kisses.
Happy birthday, little one. I remember the first day we met. I'm sure you don't, but you were still steaming and pink and wrinkly, and your dad had put you in kind of like a half baby burrito, and I got to hold and rock you for I don't know how long, but it wasn't long enough. You were so quiet and happy. You were looking around and just taking the world in. You weren't all that interested in screaming and crying like a lot of newborns I've met. And that's kind of the way you still are. You know, you just quietly get shit done and you're pretty amazing. I remember when you were older, like 7 or 8 maybe, and I'd come in to sing songs before bed, and you'd be curled up with your blanket, and I'd have to sing really fast to get all the songs in before you were asleep because you would fall asleep so quick. And then, of course, later in high school, you know, our trombone thing, and when we started getting to play at Christmas together and doing more laughing than playing, which is amazing. And, you know, we are totally holding that whole group together. I mean, let's be real. Well, I love you, and I'm so happy to know that you're happy and just thriving in life. And even though it's kind of a weird moment for your 25th birthday, I'm sure the next 25 are going to be more smooth sailing, a little less pandemic, I hope, and a great next 25. Love you, sweetie, and I'm so proud to be your mommy figure.
Happy birthday, Cameron. As I was trying to think of what I would say in this video, my thoughts were not initially drawn to some of the more adult memories like drunk Jenga or magic tricks at the table at the lake, but memories from your childhood and younger days, like how after bath time, our ritual was climbing into bed and reading books together for hours, it seems, and you would fight sleep just to stay up and hear more of the stories. And we just cuddled up there and would read. Then, of course, there's the grabbing game and the hole game, which, now that I say it, that might need some explaining, but I'll leave that up to you. And then there was a moment several years later. We were driving through Wyandotte, and we were out on Goddard Street by the railroad tracks. And a field had just blossomed. It was full of dandelions, and they had just gone to those little puffs of white. And it was dusk, and fireflies were flying over the field, and we had to stop. You insisted we stop the car, and you got out and you stretched out your arms and you ran through that field, sending thousands of little fairy umbrellas up into the sky. And I just sat there in the car and watched you, and it warmed my heart. And it still does. I'm so proud of you. You're strong, you're loving, you're fierce about the people and things that are important to you. And you make me so proud to be your daddy. I love you, Grasshopper. Happy birthday.
Then Frog ran back to Toad's house. Toad was in bed, taking a nap. Toad, said Frog, I think you should get up and wait for the mail some more.
No, said Toad. I'm tired of waiting for the mail.
Frog looked out of the window at Toad's mailbox. The snail was not there yet. Toad, said Frog, you never know when someone may send you a letter.
No, no, said Toad. I do not think anyone will ever send me a letter.
Frog looked out of the window. The snail was not there yet. But Toad, said Frog, someone may send you a letter today.
Don't be silly, said Toad. No one has ever sent me a letter before, and no one will send me a letter today.
Frog looked out of the window. The snail was still not there.
Frog, why do you keep looking out of the window? Asked Toad.
Because now I am waiting for the mail, said Frog.
But there will not be any, said Toad.
Oh, yes, there will, said Frog, because I have sent you a letter.
You have? Said Toad. What did you write in the letter?
Frog said, I wrote, Dear Toad, I am glad that you are my best friend. Your best friend, Frog.
Oh, said Toad. That makes a very good letter.
Then Frog and Toad went out onto the front porch to wait for the mail. They sat there, feeling happy together. Frog and Toad waited a long time. 4 days later, the snail got to Toad's house and gave him the letter from Frog.
Toad was very pleased to have it. Happy birthday, Cameron!
Happy birthday!
We love you!
We love you!
Cam, even though I know, despite all your incredible qualities, you're a super humble person, don't forget to give yourself some credit and congratulate yourself. Like this.
Happy birthday, Cam!